Good launch there from everybody off the row of the grid. Good start from Kevin on the inside there. Likewise, Häkkinen as well. Keep an eye out for Timmy on the outside. He tries to get the long way around the outside and does. He takes the lead at the first corner. Does Timmy Hansen. What a brilliant move. His brother Kevin, who's in second place then. And third is now Tommy Häkkinen with Gross Agent in, bearing down on him. Well, absolutely fantastic stuff there. But absolutely amazing race. And you can see there, Shoestu actually in third place. I apologise, with Gross Agent in very close behind.
Yeah, so Timmy was super committed on the way around the outside then. There was a strong chance he could have clipped the front end of Kevin's car, but narrowly missed doing that, and that would have kept him out of the barrier. So very brave from Timmy. Of course, these guys don't have spotters like they would normally do in other race series. So he just had to go off of gut feeling to cut across there. He had nobody making a call to tell him he could do that. So yeah, super brave by him.
Look at Shoestu going wide there. That allows Gross Agent in to come through into P4. Side by side, they come down to the first corner. You know Shoestu is not going to back out, but he has to eventually relinquish that position to Gross Agent in. Very impressive stuff there from the Frenchman. And now his next target, of course, is going to be Tommy Häkkinen. But he's going to have a very hard task to do that, because those two have cleared off with a bit of a gap out in front.
Yeah, the top three have just branched away, haven't they? So Gross Agent in actually 3.6 seconds back off of the trio up in front. So he's got a bit of work cut out to do, but he doesn't have Choo Choo in front of him now. So it's just whether or not he can find the pace.
Through the left-handed hairpin, there you go. And now Timmy is going to see if he can extend that advantage over his brother Kevin. But I'd say, if anything, on this lap, it's definitely come down. You can see that quite significantly. So Kevin's got good pace here by the looks of things, as has Toppy, now down from over a second to 7 tenths of a second almost there between Timmy and Kevin at the moment. But Toppy in third position is ready to take advantage if anything goes wrong. And Gross Agent in has also in turn closed that gap down to the top three at the moment.
Yeah, so maybe Gross Agent in does have a little bit of extra pace that we, more so than we maybe thought. But I think the battle is going to be on for the lead between the two brothers before long. The gap was only 6 tenths as they came across the line on the last lap. It'll be interesting to see where it is in this time around. This is the part where Kevin is slightly stronger than Timmy, I think it's fair to say, on the track. And fastest lap of the day goes to Kevin Hansen. So Kevin really on a charge.
Absolutely. He's going to run out of time though. Lap three out of four. We are on to lap four then. We go. And Kevin has got good pace, as you say, definitely in that third sector. But I think Timmy's pretty strong actually in the first sector. So it kind of balances out a little bit between the two. And that gap is sitting at a bit of a constant. The thing they need to be careful of here is that they don't ruin each other's races. I mean, they're far too experienced, I'm sure, to do something like that.
No, and Kevin is too far back to try and mount a big lunge into any of these corners, and he's not going to do that to his brother either. Of course, they both work very closely together, tactically wise, as well as, of course, in the racing they race close together as well. But they're not going to take each other out.
No, they're certainly not. Well, they won't try to, at least going into that hairpin. Here is Kevin. Look at how much closer he is to Timmy. On to the final lap we go, and Timmy just leading the way commandingly, leading it calm and cool, and exactly what we saw from him in Q1. Just not getting involved in too many squabbles. Of course, he's got Kevin, who's very close behind and trying to put that pressure onto him, but he's not getting involved in the battle with him, which in turn will be slowing both their times down.
No, it's a very smart move by both of these guys. Of course, you would expect them to be at the top of the time point standings, so that's where they want to be as well, to take an extra chunk of points away from those in the earlier races, as well as, of course, position points.
And Toppy as well, given the fact he had good pace yesterday, had almost the perfect day up until the semis and the final. It's not gone his way so far here. He's just not got the pace to keep with both the Hansen brothers at the moment. That gap has increased lap after lap, now down to 2.6 seconds to Timmy.
No, so Toppy maybe not quite got the pace today, but we've seen it all the way through the series that it's always chopping and changing between who's the quickest out of these three drivers.
So through into the right-hander we go, and out of the final corner, Timmy Hansen takes victory in Q2, race three here in Hungary. Kevin comes over the line just a second down in P2, and then Toppy Häkkinen in third position. Gross Agent in finishes in fourth, and Shoestu didn't have the luck, didn't have the pace to keep with Gross Agent in after he found his way past, made a couple of errors, and down in fifth.